Hi, this is Oleg Shevtsov from PortaOne. In this video, I'm going to give you a high-level overview of mobile services, like mobile data and voice, in roaming from a mobile operator's perspective. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding of how mobile roaming works and how online charging enables a mobile operator to monitor a user's service consumption in real time and send notifications such as SMS alerts. Let's imagine that you are on a cruise ship and you turn your mobile phone on. When I say that, most of the people watching this video will have a flashback of the bill shock that you experienced or someone from your friends experienced. Anyone who has gone to a distant land and turned on their mobile phone without preparing a plan in advance has most likely experienced some form of bill shock, even if they never made a call. The applications on your phone live their own life, sending and receiving data, even if you don't ask them to. So here is a simplified version of what happens to both your phone and the mobile operator when your phone is roaming. From the moment when the phone gets registered with the mobile network, for the sake of convenience, I'm going to call the mobile operator who originally issued your SIM card a home operator, right? Then I will call mobile operators in those distant countries you are traveling to the visiting operators. So the first thing that happens when you travel to a different country is that your phone scans for available networks. If your home network, meaning the mobile operator who issued the SIM card, is not present, then your phone will try to register with the available networks, trying to scan and connect with each network one by one. One of those local networks will receive signal and will send a request to your home operator to confirm that your phone is allowed to use the services in roaming. Your home network checks your account information and sends a response to the visiting operator to confirm that your phone is authorized to use the service in roaming. The visiting operator sends a signal to your phone to confirm that it has been registered and now can use local network services. Your home network's equipment, such as authentication and billing systems, are also involved in this process. So your account is confirmed and you are authorized to use your phone in the visiting operator's network. In some cases, the visiting operator may not have a roaming agreement with your home network. So if in a given area there is three, maybe to five network operators, only one or two may actually be able to serve you in roaming. It would depend on the preferences of your home mobile provider and the roaming agreements that your mobile network operator has with visiting networks. So now your phone is registered and it is showing a nice R roaming sign in the status bar. Let's see what happens when you use your phone. I'm going to explain how usage requests, in other words, requests to initiate a voice call or requests to use mobile data, are processed for your home network operator. And you heard me right, all usage requests in case of online charging, all usage requests are authorized by your mobile operator. Your mobile operator grants or decides whether you are allowed to, for instance, make calls or use mobile data in roaming. For example, I'm going to show you 5G network data structures because they are easier to decode and demonstrate. All the other networks, such as 4G LTE and 3G, work conceptually the same. The data structures are slightly different, and the decoding and encoding is also different. However, if you understand how it works, you will be able to apply this knowledge regardless of the network technology, be it 4G, 3G, or 5G. A typical request structure to your home mobile's operator's online charging system, which in the industry we call OCS, will include a mobile country code or MCC value. For this example, let's use MCC of 639. The code is assigned to Kenya. When a home operator receives a request from a visiting network with a mobile country code of 639, it can identify that the request was made while you are in Kenya. Then, on top of the mobile country code, there is also a second code, which is a mobile network code that identifies that specific visiting operator in Kenya the request is coming from. When your home operator's online charging system or billing system receives a request for usage while you are roaming in Kenya, it can identify that you are in Kenya. It then will determine whether you have any dedicated roaming products, such as Welcome to Kenya, 2 GB at $10 package. Alternatively, these services used in roaming could then be charged at pay-as-you-go rates from your main balance. Based on account status and products that you have purchased, your home operator may either allow or prohibit the use of services while you are in roaming. Thanks to the online charging system, your home operator can control how much services are allowed, which is good for you as a user, as it will prevent that bill shock you would otherwise experience when you get home. To sum up, accurate information about this serving network is essential for home mobile operator to correctly identify your visiting network and bill you for the usage, as well as for setting payments with their roaming partners. Mobile operators use mobile country code and mobile network codes to identify each other with the MCC and MSC information about the visiting network. Your mobile network's online charging system can identify the country you're visiting and apply the correct charging rates. Additionally, it helps your home operator to notify you of any consumption limits to avoid unexpected charges and bill shock. I hope this helps you to understand how phone charging works in roaming. At PortaOne, we provide an online charging system that tracks how much services your phone has consumed and helps providers to implement various data packs, such as 5 GB of data for roaming in Asia. If you have any interesting stories about your experience with roaming products, please feel free to post a comment. And press the like button if this video was helpful. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you, and see you in the next video.